Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Sonia Dhingra, and it's my pleasure to MC this event today. It's such a pleasure to have all of you here at the embassy today. And I'd like to invite all our distinguished guests for this evening. Today, in the continuation of its Performing India series, of cultural events, the embassy presents Monsoon Melodies, a thematic musical recital with Alif, Laila, Deepak Ram, Vijay, Ganesh, and Anirudh, Changkakoti. I request the embassy's Minister of Press and Information and Culture, Mr. Sridharan, to make his welcome remarks and a brief detail on today's events. I'd like to request that all of you turn down your mobile phones. This will be the best time to do it. And we're going to be serving refreshments after, so please join us for after the program. Thank you.
Thank you, Sonia Ji. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the embassy. This is a great evening. And first of all, I thank all of you to accommodate into the postponement of the event due to the sad demise of our former president, Dr. Abdul Kalam. I thought I'll start with one of his quotes connected to the rain, which is very inspiring. He's known for not only as a president and the scientist, but he has just made a magic out of what communication can do to youngsters. And in one of his speeches, he said, while many of the birds look for shelters whenever it rains, the eagle actually flies above the cloud. And so this is the attitude that you take towards problem that defines how you handle it. That said, we are very glad that we are able to postpone it immediately, and we started this as a tribute to him also. And this event is actually, we planned sometime last year. I'll come to that briefly. But before that, I just want to mention three things. We all know about monsoon, we all know about melodies, but there are a couple of things we may want to know slightly more. Okay. First thing is, monsoon is not a seasonal rain. And monsoon is not only part of Indian music. And monsoon music is not rain songs, right? If we understand these three things, we will appreciate this event slightly better, okay? Why monsoon is not a seasonal rain? You know, all of you know that, at least some of you know that taifeng is a Chinese word, and taifeng became typhoon. Similarly, mausam is an Arabic word that became monsoon. So it is from the root monsoon, but it's a very unique feature, only played in some parts of the globe, and the Indian subcontinent, South Asia, is one of the very important observation spots for this phenomena. But why it is so important? First thing, even today, 60% of the employment in India is in agriculture. This is a fact. Second fact, 50% of the agricultural land in India is rain-fed, rain-dependent, if rain can make or break your life. That's a fact. And the monsoon is a very unique kind of rain that is famous for its utility but notorious for its unpredictability. Every year, even now, scientists around the world could not predict monsoon correctly. Year after year, there are predictions and there are misses. And this year, happily, scientists predicted that it will not be a good rain, but this year is going to be a good rain. And we are glad whenever scientists fail this way. But what happens, the monsoon normally, when you predict that this year is going to be, say, 890 millimeters. it can fluctuate 20% from the prediction. What we all know in India is that if it rains 10% more than the prediction, it's going to flood. And hundreds of people will lose their livelihood and few lives will also be lost. Even now, as we speak, in the eastern part of India, there is a flood and people are suffering. And if the monsoon is 10% less than the prediction, then you have a drought. Then the agriculture goes down, this goes down, there is a repercussion. That's why the current president of India, Pranab Mukherjee, when he was a finance minister, once quoted saying that actually monsoon is the real finance minister of India. Because monsoon can decide how your finances for that year. Right? So that's why monsoon is not just a seasonal rain. It's much more than that. That brings me to the second point, that monsoon is not just about melodies. You take Indian culture, starting from Rig Veda, which is the ancient text. It's a oral text. We don't know the date of it. And from the time it registered, it goes a few thousand years before the birth of Christ. So you can predict where it goes, right? That has lines about monsoon and rain and the importance of rain. Something like, then the wind flows. Then the lightning comes down. Then the flora sprouts and grows. Then the space evolves. Then the god of rain prepares the land for welfare, for the welfare of everyone. Right? These are very pure thoughts. And actually it is said that when you chant this in the technically prescribed sound, it can bring rain. In the medieval period also, medieval India also, there are people who have sung particular ragas, particular patterns, and then brought rains. So from this ancient text, you take theater, dance, culture, anything, the monsoon is prevailing everywhere. It's a very, very substantial, predominant element of Indian culture. Now that comes to this performance where we are talking about monsoon melodies. It's very easy to say that, okay, they are going to sing or they are going to touch upon some music which talks about rain, but it's untrue. In Indian musical system, the music has patterns. I don't want to get into details. Many of you know, this is a mixed audience where some of you can teach me, some of you probably are the first time. So let me break a middle path and say that these patterns are not about the content. Without getting into the word rain or monsoon, you can make one feel rain. And this is again not a single composition. It's a pattern, you can reuse it. Like if you have an Indian motif, you can do a sari, you can do a chudidar, you can do anything. Just look around and you will know what I'm talking about, right? So similarly, these musical patterns, which touch upon the theme of monsoon, can be utilized in so many ways. So there, today, we are very grateful that exemplary musicians like Alif, Deepak, Vijay, and Anirudh, they have come together to present to us a set of musical patterns which will relate to rain. Now, I'll give you a backstory. Last year, we planned this. So this event was curated at least 1 year ahead. And last year, we could not present this event. And this year, when again, there was a postponement, we were just crossing our fingers, and we are glad that this is happening. And we are also glad that Alif is also an artist. She paints. So she has a few paintings which are based on monsoon and rain. And so she has kindly agreed that these can be projected today while the music is going to come. So you're going to have more than for your ears, something for your eyes also, apart from, of course, their colorful dresses. So I also join with all of you and look forward to this event. Welcome you all again. Thank you.
So let me remind you guys to turn off your telephones one more time, okay? I'd like to introduce all of the artists as I request them to come on stage. I'll start with Alif. Alif Laila is one of the very few internationally performing female sitar players of today. She was initiated to sitar by the late Ustad Mir Kasim Khan, nephew of Ustad Alauddin Khan in Dhaka, Bangladesh. She has performed in venues like the Kennedy Center, the Smithsonian, the Purcell Room, South Bank Center in London, the Metropolitan Museums of Art New York, the Harkness Hall, Yale, Delhi, and SRA Kolkata. Alif has several music albums to her credit, including I Am Rain, Amma, and The Chakra. She has been recently awarded a grant from the Arts and Humanities Council in Montgomery County, Maryland, for her upcoming CD recording, Connections with Tanmoy Bose, with world melodies and percussion. Alif recently established her musical school, Sitar Niketan, in Washington, D.C. Please welcome Alif. I'd like to invite Deepak to come on stage. Deepak has performed Hindustani and classical music. Apart from the US, Deepak has performed in South Africa, India, United Kingdom, Ireland, France, Austria, Germany, Lebanon, Turkey, Holland, and has the honor of accompanying his teacher, and Pandit Haridas Prasad. Hari Prasad Chaurasia, sorry, in Geneva, London, and Paris. Deepak has 8 solo albums to his credit, and as a session musician, can be heard all of his 25 albums. He's a winner of several prestigious awards. Deepak holds a master's degree in music from Rhodes University, South Africa. He served as visiting professor in Indian music at the University of California, Santa Cruz. He has lectured full-time for 4 years at the University of Durban, Westville, South Africa. Please welcome Deepak Ram. I'd like to welcome Vijay Ganesh. Vijay Ganesh has learned the ancient percussion instrument Mridangam from age 6. His guru is the late Sri Kumbha Konam Rajappa Iyer. He has performed extensively in India, USA, and Canada. Vijay has accompanied many eminent musicians, including Dr. Bala Murli Krishna, Pandit Vishwa Mohan, Bhatt, Unikrishna, Maharaja Puram Ramachandran, and Anupama Bhagwat. He has won many awards, including Best Mridangaist from the Music Academy and Krishna Gana Sabat. Thank you. Please welcome. I'd like to welcome Anirudh, Alva, Changkakoti. Anirudh started learning tabla from the age of 3 with Dr. Narendra Varma, disciple of the illustrious Ustad Alarakha. He has performed at the Kennedy Center and in various venues across many states in the USA, Canada, and the national television in India. For the past 6 years, Anirudh has been learning from the maestro Ustad Zakir Hussain. Anirudh is a junior at James Madison University. Please welcome all of the artists. And I'm going to hand the mic to Alif Laila.
Good evening. Thank you, Sonia, and thank you, Dharanji, for introducing us and talking about what is about to happen. And thank you all for being here. It's a great honor and it's a great pleasure that we, Deepak, Vijay, and Anirudh, and I are going to attempt to express our feelings of when that time comes where it's not enough, words are not enough, painting is not enough, music is not, we don't know how to express it. So we are going to try and see how we can do it. We have a few words coming in later in poetry form. So we're going to try our best to bring all elements of expression. Hopefully we will convey what we are feeling through the rags and the tals to convey you our feelings. We sometimes forget about the reality, about the economy or the significance of the rain, whether there's enough crop or anything. At that moment, we forget everything. So please do excuse us for that, being so emotional and so just into our form of life, of a way of life. So we're going to begin with Rag Megh, and Deepak is going to talk about.
Good evening, friends, and thank you for attending this event. Personally, I'm very pleased to be on stage for the second time with Alif, Laila, Vijay, Ganesh, and Anirudh, Changkakoti. So Rag Megh is one of the early ragas, which is kind of based on a seasonal raga, which is obviously monsoon. So every raga is based on a certain time period or a certain time frame. The science of, like as Dharanji explained, ragas are based on sympathetic resonance, like Vedic mantras. If pronounced properly, has a certain effect. It's all based on the science of sympathetic resonance, which raga imbibes to. So Rag Megh is basically a rain season raga, and of course we're going to start with Alap, which is free of time, followed by Jor, which has a certain pulse, and the quintessence of this music is improvisation. So just bear that in mind. We create as we go on. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All for you, Dharanji. I must say that Dharanji being in this area has inspired all of the artists to be more creative, to be better and better.
So now we're going to do the quintessential rain season raga, which is contemporary in Indian classical music. This is the quintessential rain season raga more than make. So this is rag Mia Ki Malhar. It's a version of Malhar which is traditional, but Mia Thansen in 13th century added some variation to it, and now we call it Mia Ki Malhar. So Alif ji is going to recite the poem. So we're going to play a composition within this raga based on a Mira version. So Alif ji is going to recite the Hindi dialect of that region, which is Rajasthan, and I'll read out the translation of this Mira version, which talks about the poetic and the aesthetics of rain season, and including this, you know, spirituality, music, art in India. We do not consider it. You know, just to quote a famous master, you know, we, for thousands of years we've been a nation of not believers but seekers. So a nation of seekers can only create a multitude of art forms.
Thank you. So this is Mira had left the worldly, everything worldly about her in devotion of Krishna. So Mira Bhajan is the love, the devotional spirit of towards Krishna, and we are still for hundreds and hundreds of years, we can't get over it, of course. It's intensifying more and more. So this bhajan is based on Krishna. She's comparing it with the clouds, the rain, and the depth, the dark. Dark is beautiful. So, badal dekh rari mein, badal dekh rari ho sham. बादल देख रड़ी मैं काली पीली घट घड़ी बरसों ए घड़ी मैं बादल देख रड़ी जित चाओ तित पानी पानी हुई सभी भूम हरी जाके पिया परदेस बसत है भीजे बहर खड़ी मीरा के प्रभु है हरि अविनाशी मीरा के प्रभु हरि अविनाशी कीजे प्रीत खड़ी मैं बादल देख रड़ी शाम बादल देख रड़ी
सो द इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन आई ट्राई टू साउंड एज पोएटिक एज पॉसिबल इवन दो आई साउंड लाइक यू नो समवन ऑफ अ डिफरेंट स्पीसीज Dark clouds filling up the sky, I look at the darkening sky and shiver in fear. As if the sky has worn a dark veil today. Now it's water all around, I look in dismay. The earth is drenched and covered in green. I drench in rain all alone, and my beloved is far away from me. O Krishna, O eternal divine, your love is my only hope. And I hope it's true.
I must say, Vijay's voice is made for poetry. Wonderful. Thank you. rain is kind of the clouds, the sky, everything is coming together, and we couldn't think of anything else but Tagore. In Tagore's Desh composition, Esho Shyamalo Sundaro, it has all the colors, the textures together, from the deep depth to the lightness of romance. So I'm going to recite again in Bengali, and Deepak, with his deep voice, is going to recite in English. And we are going to get going with Desh in Tintal and Jhala. We might have some rain outside. Please don't blame us. So here it goes. Esho Shyamalo Sundaro, Alo Tabo Tapohara Trishahara Sango Shudha. বিরহিণী চাহিয়া আছে আকাশে সে যে ব্যথিত হৃদয়ে আছে বিছায়ে তমাল কুঞ্জ পথে সজল ছায়াতে নয়নে জাগেছে করুণ রাগিনী বকুল মুকুল রেখেছে গাথিয়া বাজেছে অঙ্গনে মিলন বাঁশরি আন তব তোমার মন্দিরা চঞ্চল নৃত্যেরও বাজিবে ছন্দেশে বাজিবে কঙ্কন বাজিবে কিঙ্কিনে ঝঙ্কারিবে মঞ্জির রুনু রুনু
কাম ও ক্লাউডস ডার্ক এন্ড বিউটিয়াস কাম কাম উইথ ইয়োর নেক্টার দ্যাট কুলস এন্ড কোয়েঞ্চেস অল আদার অল থার্স্ট শি পাইন্স ফর ইউ সেপারেটেড লুকিং আপ এট দ্য স্কাই She who has spread out a heart that is aching, so on the shadows of the most moist tamal grows, and in whose eyes are awake the ragini's doleful strains. She strung for you garlands of bakul buds. In a courtyard sings the flute of the union of love. That's why I play flute. Bring with you your mandira, which is those finger cymbals that will resound to the beats of the pulsating dance, or dance as in Americans. When the kankans clink and the kinkinis chime and the manjiras jingle, runu, 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 runu.
Runu, runu, runu.
Thank you.
Wow. That was so special. My gosh. Another round of applause. Wow. If it hasn't rained, I don't know. Wow. On behalf of the embassy, we thank all of you for coming here tonight, and I'd like to ask Minister Sridharan to come and present bouquets to the artists. To Anirudh. To Vijay, Ganesh. Wow, amazing. To Deepak Ram, fantastic. And to Alif, Laila. Wow. Please join us for some refreshments.
I have one for you.
Oh my gosh. Thank you so much.
A couple of announcements before we go in. Of course, if this is not rain, what is? Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Someone said that, you know, only a few occasions you walk in the rain, otherwise you normally get wet. And this is one occasion where we were really drenched in complete monsoon. Thank you so much. The couple of events that are coming up on August 13th, this month is the Indian Independence Day, it's coming on 15th. So we have some special events. On August 13th, we are going to have, under the Beholding India series, a screening of a documentary shot in India, not yet released anywhere. It is called India Awakes. It's about the common people of India and how the transformation is happening in India. And we'll be sending the invitation soon. On August 20th, we will have the Bollywood actor Anupam Kher coming here for a panel discussion on the contemporary Indian theater and the cinema scene. What's the connection? And the end of August, we will have a program based on Indian rhythms called The Sound of Freedom. And we will send that information also. On September 12th, again, there is another event coming up. And we will keep you posted. This is for August. Yeah. Thank you so much. And join us for the dinner. Thank you.